La 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 baba doo doo da doo 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 da. Bo 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 doo 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 da 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 da. Ooh da 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 da. Bonsoir mes amis. Hey, hey. Alors, c'est moi, Georges. Je suis en escargot. C'est tout. Bonsoir, everybody. See, that's all the French I know, everybody. No, I know a little more French, of course, because I am French. I'm also a talking snail, so right there you got, that's the, what they call in Hollywood, the double threat. Now, we've received a lot of emails and faxes, because we still have a fax machine here. I mean, do you believe this crap? The other late night talk show hosts have got bands, and we have a fax machine. Anyway, we got a few faxes and emails from concerned people who said, wait a minute. Snails don't have eyes on their face like humans. They have their eyes on the little pointy bits here, like this. And normally, of course, that is true of American snails. But I am a European snail. I know the ways of love. I leave a trail of slime. I leave a trail of slime. Like regular snails and lawyers. But European snails, their eyes are close, like this. You know why? I'll tell you why. It's a rhetorical question. Don't talk back to me. I'll tell you why. Because it's easier to look the ladies in the eye and say, hey. Ever done it with a dude in a shell? And the ladies are all like, no, no, get away from me, you're disgusting. But soon they relent because I am, of course, charming. And I know how to listen. Yes, I can see you're right about that. Why, of course, 15 cats is not too many. Do you know what I hate about, well, I know this is going on too long, but I'm a snail, it takes a long time. So shut up, all right? You know what I used to hate? You know that cartoon, Pepe Le Pew? Well, he's a skunk, he's from France, and what always happens is a cat is walking by, a lady cat is walking by, and some white paint falls on the lady cat, and then she looks a little bit like a skunk, and Pepe Le Pew the skunk chases her all over the place. Every cartoon, it's always the same. I hate that. All right, peace out.
Tomorrow, okay? Hey, hey! Tomorrow! gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
Thank you. Please, enough. I have to tell you. No, please. No. That's enough. No. Enough owing, please. Just before I came out, not came out. Oh, well, you might as well know. No, just before I was standing back there, which in the street, you can see out the window, I was in the street. Now, I've done, how many of these shows have I done? Like a billion or something? This is like 976. So this is show 976. And every night before I get... Oh, yeah, yeah. You're clearly high on something. Anyway, show 976 will go down in history because... Well, it won't, but it nearly did, because just before I came out... Not came out. Oh, yeah. I was standing back there, and my fly was open. Now, if you know me intimately, and a few of you do, you'll know that for me, that's dangerous. It's not just the normal, oh, you could see a bit of underwear. I get stuff down there that needs contained. I mean, if I'd have come, you think the cheering was loud, Dan? You wait, if that had come out like that, I'd be like, ha! Ah! And then. Yeah. But the awkward pauses would have been longer. Because, you know, the thing is, that's why you should always, if you ever have to do any public speaking, not that I'm equating this with something like public speaking, but. But you can't look down, you can't check. Once you're out, your head has to keep going to the front. You can't suddenly go like that. Well, you can't look. Anyway, even although I've got my fly pulled up in time, it's still a great day for America, everybody. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. And I'll tell you why, because it is today. Sesame Street is 40 years old today. Happy birthday, Sesame Street. Yep. Happy birthday. Officially now, middle aged. Cookie Monster's gonna have to switch to the low carb diet. There'll be. You thought Oscar was grouchy before. Wait till he gets that prostate exam. You wait, man! A middle aged dude there is like, yeah, oh, man. Also, Google announced today that they're giving free internet access in airports all across the country. I think this is fantastic. Up until now, the only way to see something pornographic in an airport is follow a senator into a bathroom. But now... ShoeTappers.com. Is that a real one? I bet you it is. There probably is one. All right. CBS is not in any way endorsed. Now, last night I mentioned that Wednesday of this week is Polish Independence Day, and it is. I'm very excited. As you know, I feel very close to the Polish community. I only found out about it yesterday, but I... Anyway, we are very excited that Polish Independence Day is coming, and we've got a graphic made and everything. Do we have a graphic for Polish Independence Day? Yeah! Polish Independence Day. Polish people all across America are like, finally. Anyway, a great day for America, not such a great day for former Miss California, big guy Carrie Prejean. It's a French name, isn't it? Prejean. Last year, she, you remember, she got fired last year from Donald Prump. Donald Prump. Yeah, I think Prump is fine. Yeah, yeah. She got fired by Donald Prump's beauty pageant. And now she says it was because of her stance on gay marriage. I think it's because she wouldn't touch that furry thing on his head. Whatever it was, she got fired. Anyway, she got into trouble recently for doing the risky photo shoot. Now, for those of you who are not good with the names, you don't know who I'm talking about, but you never forget a booby. That dude over there. Here's one of the sexy photographs. You can look at it. That's it there. Yeah. Yeah, look at that. That's the gay coalition sign over there. Now, when the photo came out, Miss California said it was an accident because the wind blew open her vest. And I'm thinking, now, what kind of windy day blows open your top but leaves your hair perfect? Because I'm thinking, it's like, there's a wind, but it's only up to my neck. Anyway, today it was revealed that the former Miss California, Carrie Price, she also made a sex tape. That was like a squeak of joy from a dude. He was like, oh! So long, sucker! Now, here's the news. She's made a sex tape, and she's the only one in the tape. Now, to be fair, maybe it was completely innocent. Maybe she was just standing there, and the wind blew one of her hands. Maybe the wind blew her other hand. The wind kept blowing her into different positions until something awesome happened. Anyway, now. Now, a lot of people are giving her a hard time. She doesn't support gay marriage. And now, it's her right. Whether or not you agree with her, she's an American. She's got a right to say she doesn't support gay marriage. But whatever your stance is on gay marriage, it is your right to enjoy this sex tape. That's all I'm saying. For one, feel it is my patriotic duty to investigate this thing further. Also, I have to say, who cares what Miss America says? She's not an elected position. She's not an arbiter of social justice. It's not like, well, I don't know. We've talked to the UN. We've run it past the Senate. Yeah, we better get out of the Miss America position on this as well. Come on, our main skill is looking good in a wind-blowing vest. A skill I share with her. Anyway, all I'm saying is that, you know, when a slightly, not to be cruel, but a slightly dim-witted, is that too? Slightly dim-witted, slightly naive, let's say. When a naive beauty queen starts tackling political questions, it doesn't end well. Ask Sarah Palin. Just take a break. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the big show, where we're changing the face of late night. Not really. Pretty much a dude, middle-aged white dude at a desk talking. That's new, it's bold! No, it's not. Oh, well, never mind. This is from Diane in Lino Lakes in Minnesota. I've been to Minnesota. It's land of 1,000 lakes. Although, what classifies as a lake in Minnesota, to be honest, in many other states would be considered a puddle. Like, oh, look at all these lakes. You go, well, no, there's one lake and a couple of other kind of bits. Of, like, you know, there's not really lake, it's kind of lake suburbs. So I don't know if they all count as lakes, is what I'm saying. Anyway, Minnesota is my favorite state. I love everybody. Diane says, if you had to write a six-word memoir of your life, what would it be? Also, how do they contact Batman during the day? You ask too much, Diane. I don't know how they get Batman. Well, you can't get Batman during the day. He's got a job. He's stately Bruce Wayne. That's who he is, right? He doesn't have a job. He's like a trust fund kid or something, isn't he? That's why it's not believable, because all these trust fund guys are douchebags. None of them are Batman. Like, if you have guys with that amount of money, they're all going around New York trying to give cocaine to models. They're not helping people. Well, they're helping the models, I guess. Oh, no, there goes the valuable trust fund demographic. Go and watch your cable, you rich bastards. All right. If you had to write a six-word memoir of your life, what would it be? Oh, jeez, I was drunk. It was great. Six words. Wow. This is from Hannah in Gustavus, Ohio. See if I had been a Roman general, I would have called myself Gustavus, Ohio. General Gustavus, Ohio. Hey, Craig, says Hannah. I was on the Urban Dictionary website the other day, and I noticed there actually is a word, fergasm. And it meant something your fans get when you act sexy. Isn't that awesome? Is that true? No. It'll be from Fergie from the Black Eyed Peas. She's sexy, and her name's Fergie. Yeah. What's her name, Stacey Ferguson? Margaret? I don't know. Anyway, the Fergie in the Black Eyed, she's the sexy one. I'm the other side of the Ferguson spectrum. That's kind of worrying. And sexy. What are you doing right now? You make me feel ashamed. You make me feel like a wind is gonna blow open my... This is from Simon in Chicago and Krakow, which is in Poland. It's a coincidence. Says, Craig, I was born in Poland, and I can assure you that the poorest places in Warsaw look better than your studio. I have no doubt. I have no doubt. This is from Jack in Indianapolis, Indiana. He says, Dear Craig, not to spoil Polish Independence Day celebration, but a couple of us who used to be in the military are celebrating a silly little thing called Veterans Day on Wednesday. Thought that might be worth pointing out. Oops. All right. All right, first of all, I'd like to apologize to the people of Poland. Because you're not getting the big celebration tomorrow night. We're going to have to make it Veterans Day, and we'll have to have a new graphic. And we'll have Polish Independence Day next year. Well, wait. There'll be Veterans Day next year as well. All right, we'll have Veterans Day with a special emphasis on Polish Americans who served in the military at various points. How about that? Yes, Veterans Day with a subsect including Polish American veterans. What could be fairer? You know, luckily, that guy whose email I've thrown on the floor and I can't remember your name, luckily, I have a team of producers and researchers here who would never let me make an embarrassing mistake like that. We can cut that out. Anyway, this is... I know you want me to finish, but then again, you could have told me about Veterans Day, so... Ooh la la! All right? This is from Chris in Nashville in Tennessee. He says, hey, Craig, do you have any advice on how to pick up women that doesn't involve lying? What? No. And you better think again, mister, about the way you're approaching this. This is totally wrong. How do you expect to get into a committed relationship without being honest? I don't think you pick up women, to be honest. I don't think men ever picked up women. I don't think that's what happens. If women pick up men, women decide. They do. Whenever I've got involved with a woman, it's never been me. I think I'm involved. I don't know. That's not true. I stand there going, oh. Like, when you go over, Chris, in Nashville, when you walk up to a lady and you lie to her, she knows you're lying. She's just trying to decide if you're hot enough for her not to care. We'll be right back, everyone. Welcome back to the Veterans Day Eve special. Now, I know what you're thinking. I know what you're thinking at home. You're thinking, well, Craig, come on. We know this thing's pre-taped. You do it during the day, and then you put it out a couple hours later. So you could easily stop and fix it, and then you would never, we'd never know. And then I think, yeah, you could, but then I'd have to do this twice, and they don't pay me enough. They really don't. Anyway, my next guest is an actor who stars in The Sons of Anarchy, which is on Tuesdays on the FX. Please welcome Adam Arkin, everybody. Adam Arkin. Welcome, Adam.
Thank you, sir.
Nice to see you, pal.
Good to see you. I feel the 977th episode, Polish Independence Day, Veterans Day, and your fly being open, it's like some sort of harmonic convergence.
That was so.
I'm so proud to be here.
But you're describing tomorrow's show, except for the fly being open.
Oh,
which,
am I? Oh, I.
Yeah, no, this is 976.
I heard that this was 977. Is it
this
changed?
This is 977? Oh, I've done 900. This is 977.
But it's your pipeline.
I'm sorry,
it's
man.
Gone,
I'm just so.
It's
I'm
gone
just.
To hell.
Yeah, it really is. Do you have any Polish in your background at all?
Not that I know of. No.
Well, that's good because we're not celebrating Polish Independence Day.
All right.
We're gonna do Veterans Day. You ever in the military?
No, I was not.
Well, this is a way of you showing your gratitude.
I have nothing but gratitude.
Well, there you go.
I have a
great
uncle that was a war hero, so.
Well, there you go. That's perfect. And now we have a graphic.
Really?
Yeah, apparently it's ready. Look, we have a graphic. But look, it's Veterans Day. Including Polish American veterans. There you are. That was a dangerous situation we managed to get out of. This, the Sons of Anarchy show looks very exciting. You're very bad in it.
I'm an evil SOB on the SOA show, yeah.
Sons of Anarchy,
yes.
Yeah, the last one I couldn't get, the SOA. Yeah. You're a heroin dealer?
No, that's just a sideline. I'm actually a... I'm a white separatist, and just a nefarious guy all the way around.
Is white separatist a job?
Yes. I didn't say it was lucrative.
Yeah, it's more a kind of volunteer position.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And I got a lot of flack. You know, people ask a lot of questions like, how do you feel about taking on this role? As if somehow I was endorsing the position. But sort of like, you know, when Anthony Hopkins played Hannibal Lecter, he wasn't telling people to go out and eat human beings. Not that I'm comparing... He was? And not that I'm comparing myself to Anthony Hopkins.
No, I know Anthony Hopkins. I call him Tony.
Really?
Yeah. I say Tony, and he says, who said that? No,
it's you.
You. Oh, what happened? Why can't I get on a good show?
This is a good show.
No, it's all right.
Don't sell yourself short.
The Sons of Anarchy, that's a good show. The heroin dealing that you do on the sideline. Have you done any heroin in your own life?
I don't remember.
I did it a couple of times.
Yeah.
Pfft, it's bad.
Overrated?
Kind of, yeah. It's just like, it's like all the glory of having the flu without the time off work. Well, to say no, kids.
When you finally get the time off of work, it's sort of a permanent deal.
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah, no, it's a bad business. So other things then. What have you been up to?
Things have been great.
No heroin then? No, you haven't been doing any heroin.
What is it? Did someone tell you something about my past that I didn't know?
No, I tore up the card. Now I got nothing, you see?
All right, there's been a lot of heroin.
Really?
All right,
fine. You look so healthy now.
So happy to have it off my chest.
Oh.
No.
I came out earlier on, apparently, as well.
You came out with your fly open.
I know. Yeah. If you're going to do it.
Do
dang,
it all the
dang,
way.
Clang at the trolley.
I'm glad you caught that, because I'm insecure enough as it is.
Are you really? Are you sexually insecure?
I don't need to be compared to funny Scotsmen in that department.
Oh, you mean downstairs department? Yeah. Are you a shy man? Is that your thing? Are you very kind of...
For someone that chose to get into this business, I guess you could say I'm reasonably shy, yeah.
Well, no sex tape of you. You don't have a sex tape, then?
It's not a sex tape, it's sex film of me, but it's also, unfortunately, it...
How terribly impressive. Is it widescreen?
It's stills. And it unfortunately syncs up with one of those cameras that catches you going through an intersection. and it's just me by myself.
Oh, wow. So you've got the whole... So you're driving an automatic, then?
But I've paid my debt to society, and I'm free to talk about it now.
Oh, I do like that idea very much. I'd pay money to see that photograph, actually. And you drive a convertible, then? Yeah. Do you drive a convertible?
No, I don't.
All right. Yeah. What about motorcycles? There's a lot of motorcycles then that you know.
I don't drive motorcycles. I was enamored being around as many beautiful motorcycles as I was on the show. And at one point I was like, can I sit on this? And they're like, sure. And I was like, can I take the kickstand up? And they're like, sure. And I was like, oh my,
there's
gonna
happen.
And the idea of going 80 miles an hour with something that weighs that much and nothing between you and clear blue sky.
It's not the sky you worry about, it's the tarmac you don't worry about.
Yeah,
I had a motorcycle accident. I broke three ribs and a collarbone.
You've done everything, though.
Most of it drunk.
Were you drunk on the bike?
Nah. I did have a motorcycle accident once drunk, and nothing happened. I was fine. Yeah. It was the sober one that took me out.
Yeah. You tense up.
A little bit, yeah. I was tense. Yeah. Well, what do you do then if you don't ride the motorcycles or take heroin? Don't you have a hobby?
I admit, yeah. I cook. I'm a photographer. I play drums, which I understand you do also.
No, I used to a while ago. Yeah,
well, that's once a drummer. Once a drummer, always a drummer. No, I think.
I like playing drums. Yeah, it's fun.
We should like jam sometime.
Have a drum circle.
Why not?
Nice.
A two-man drum circle.
And make a tape. We gotta go, Adam. It's nice to see you.
It's
again.
Very nice to see you.
Adam Arkin, everybody, we were in. Welcome back to the big show where we get everything wrong.
But we're charming.
And we're enthusiastic. What we lose by being incompetent and buffoons, we make up with a positive attitude and a gee willikers, everything's gonna be all right attitude. Guest is a judge on Project Runway. Ha ha! Which is on Thursdays on Lifetime. Take a look at this.
Surprise.
Surprise.
Oh, wow. Hello.
Hey, guys.
I did not expect them to be here. Not ever.
The two of us just wanted to give you a few tips, a few pointers, if we could.
Advice is always great, especially when it's from Nina and Michael.
If it feels like something else, if it feels like something that you've seen before, take it out. Because this show is about you guys.
Please welcome the very lovely Nina Garcia, everybody. Nina Garcia. Welcome, Nina. I am very excited to meet you, and you look sensational, may I say.
Thank you.
You are in no way.
Thank you.
Well, thank you very much. This is what we call Bob Barker 1974. But you don't disappoint. You've come on very stylishly, and
thank you.
I like your necklace very much as well.
Thank you.
What is that?
It's costume jewelry.
Oh, really? I mean this in the nicest possible way. It's slightly like a bicycle chain.
Well, that's...
Have you ever taken heroin?
No, but I am from Colombia.
Well, no, that's a completely... What different drug stereotype. Let's move on.
But, you know, fashion loves to play with those S&M and those heroin chic. And
not just fashion. I have to say, no, I am a huge fan of Project Runway, and I've been watching this season very, very closely. And I have to say, with the great, as being as positive as I can, I think the show has suffered a bit this season because you and Michael haven't been on all the episodes. You and Michael are kind of the bitches, but which is fine because you both do it with such class and niceness, you know. But anyway, yeah. But what it's done is it's positioned Heidi to be very hard on the, and I don't think that's her natural inclination, given that she's German.
No, of course not. Those Germans have no track record.
Not at all. Easy going. They're the kind of what's a coming a go types. Oh, mañana, they say, and they're laughing as they march up and down. Now, how did you get involved in fashion? What drew you into it? You just love fashion? Were you a designer?
I loved it from the beginning. When I was growing up, I wanted to be a designer. Little did I know how hard that could be.
Yeah.
No, but I really had a fascination with fashion from the beginning, and I used to sketch, and I knew that I would be.
Where did you grow up, in Colombia?
I grew up in Colombia, and then I came to live in the U.S. when I was 15 to go to school here.
Right.
And I, you know, went to school for fashion. Everything was surrounding fashion, so all my background, I knew from the beginning that...
Is it a very bitchy world? Is it very, very kind of nasty? I get the sensation that everyone's quite cruel, which I love.
It can be a little competitive.
Yes, I think so.
It can be a little competitive, but not everybody needs to be mean. It's changing. The industry is changing.
Oh, come on now. Nina. Don't lie to me, it's me.
No, it's getting better. It's getting
really?
Better. But it is very competitive.
And very competitive. You know who I'm very impressed with that you had on the show? Well, not this season, earlier season. Diane von Fustenberg.
Oh, she's that, terrific.
She's. Well, do you know her?
Yes, I love Diane.
Yeah, she me is... too. I've never met her.
You
but
have, or you have to have her on your show.
Okay.
She's got a terrific. I mean, her whole life story is just compelling, and she's
well,
done.
It wouldn't work here then. We don't even know it's Veterans Day tomorrow.
No, she's a fantastic lady. She's doing a lot of great things for the industry. She has a great line of clothes that has been very successful, and she has a wonderful story that everybody should know.
What is her story then? She's an immigrant as well? That she
yes,
came from...
Her mother came from the concentration camp. It's just a fantastic story that everybody should know about.
Now, the thing that drew me to Project Runway and why I like it so much, and I wonder if the fashion world is like this, that it's a complete meritocracy. It doesn't seem to me that it matters who you are. It's how good you are at what you do. Is that true?
Yes, it requires you have to have a talent, you have to have a skill. I think the other thing that is fantastic about the show is that it's about creating. It's the process of creation. It's about making something. And that's fascinating, and everybody can participate and have an opinion on it.
Right.
You're creating something, and that's what's always fascinated me about fashion.
That's what fascinates me about the show, because I clearly I'm not that interested in fashion.
And
but
you're a straight man. I love that you're a straight man watching the show.
No, there's a lot of straight men watching the show. We get together in little groups, drink beer, and scratch ourselves and go, can you believe it? It's the guilty pleasure of a lot of straight men, I tell you.
I thought it was just my husband.
No, a lot. What's happening next year? Are you going back to New York?
We're in New York, guys, and we're all there the entire time.
Oh, thank the Lord! That's it.
It's a great season.
Good.
It's a great season.
And please give my fondest regards to Tim Gunn, who has very kindly been here many times and twice. But that in show business, that means many times, as you know.
Yes, he's amazing.
Yeah, he was Aquaman when he was here, you know.
No, he wasn't.
He did. He did Aquaman. We did some Aquaman sketches. He was Aquaman.
I can't imagine that. Yeah. But I've seen Tim Gunn dance. I don't know if you've seen him dance.
Tim Gunn dance? I heard tell of such a thing, but I didn't believe it. Really? How can he dance? He's so elegant. They're dancing. Oh,
well, at Lifetime, you could see anything's possible.
I guess. Tim, you didn't dance when you were here.
Well, next time you have to have him dance.
All right, I'll make him dance. I think I have a way. Nina, it's lovely to finally
meet
you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for coming on the show, and good luck with the rest of... when's Fashion Week again? Next September?
February.
Around
the corner.
It's coming up already.
Thank you.
It's lovely to meet you, Nina. Nina Garcia, everybody. We were right there. I'll tell you what I learned on the show. I learned that tomorrow is Veterans Day, which also coincides with Polish Independence Day. And I also just learned that it is Marine Day today. So, thank you, United States Marine Corps. Thank you, veterans. And hello, Poland. Good night, everybody. Good night.